Today we're going to be playing some part 4 of Paper Mario. I usually like to stay quiet in these videos so you can see the gameplay, you know. I figured today I'd talk a little bit in it. This is right here, like I said, we call it part 4. And I think I gotta go over here and talk to this one person because they're looking for some seeds. What I'm supposed to do here. So let's see here. Jump back down here real quick. Ah. Nope. No, thank you. There's Luigi. Go over here. Talk to a few of these people. These guys. Excuse me, there we go. They got that little toad. There we go. Try to let y'all read what they're saying too.
I'm trying to take my time on that. Wow, that didn't help none, did it? I'd like to check the area before I leave too. I'd like to do a full check on it. I need some more people to fight over here so I can level up. Fortune teller. You find a couple of these throughout the whole game. Nah. Hey, David. I see you, David. Yeah, a lot of y'all don't know probably that my daughter's in the background of these videos. Sometimes you hear something sound like a baby, that's her. Hey, here's one of these things. Star piece. Jerry. Getting excited? Paper Mario?
Yeah.
Ah, here we go. Story dude. Right up here. We want to talk to him definitely. I mean, that's the whole point.
Only thing I don't like about when you talk to these people like that is you see how the writing comes in. You see how that writing comes in right there. It comes in kind of like staticky looking. That's kind of hard to read sometimes.
And I'm also doing more videos, like more game videos, well, on different games, but I've been focusing a lot on Paper Mario because, fortunately, it has a lot of great save spots, which means I can play from here to there and then save it while filming it. It makes it a lot more easier to do. I like the background of that little castle right there. That's kind of cool. There's old Bowser.
I haven't played this game since
I was a little thing. That's probably about 2003, 2004. And I just recently got it again, you know. So that's pretty cool. My granddad was a big fan of Mario. He liked Mario 64. That was his game. And now that guy beat that Mario 64 at least a good couple hundred, maybe even 1,000 times. He just would constantly play it. He was really good at it. But he was the guy to ask about the Mario 64. Tried to get him into this one and he just didn't care for this game too much. He wasn't into like the RPGs. He was a huge fan of the Mario series from the 64, Super, and original Nintendo. I'm gonna put out a couple more game videos today too of other games.
One thing about this game is there's a lot of cutscenes to it, which really add to the story.
That's kind of cool. I like it because it's a, it reminds me of Final Fantasy, man. to go after here in so long. I'll figure it out though. Can't hurt to go back up there and look around again.
house is spending the repairs. So I hear my
Ah, yep. Mario done fell asleep. He's like, I ain't want to see him, right?
So you have to go here now. Small little room. Here comes the chain, man. I like it.
missing my attacker, dude. Just gonna take a minute. There we go, finally got it. Do that again right here. I didn't do what I thought. This. I don't know what to do here. I'm about to finish this guy off real quick. Keep doing this stuff, eat them all. But right off, man. Okay. Right off the bat, I'm going to use fire flower. Boom. See you. Using his fire mushroom and fire flower. There, eat that mushroom real quick. I think I might actually get beat right here. Got it with him. He's gonna get twice, you already know. Sure he's gonna beat me, to be honest.